Good evening, and welcome to Hartman Public School's virtual graduation.
Everyone, I would like to start by acknowledging that we are on the traditional territories of the Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, and the Anishinaabe peoples, whose presence here continues to this day. We would also like to acknowledge that the land we are on is at the meeting place of two treaties, the land of the Mississaugas of the Credit and those of the First Nation of the Williams Treaty. We would like to thank them and other Indigenous peoples for the sharing this land with us. We would also like to acknowledge the Chippewas of Georgina Islands First Nation as our closest Indigenous community and our partners in education. We acknowledge this land and the people because the first step to reconciliation is recognizing the existence of Indigenous people. The Truth and Reconciliation Commission of Canada calls to action speaks to the significance of education as the key to reconciliation, a shared understanding of how our collective past brought us to where we are today will help us walk together into a better future.
Congratulations to you, our graduating class of 2021. Graduations are something I look forward to all year because it's such a pivotal milestone in all of our lives and an amazing opportunity to celebrate your hard work and dedication. This year, they are particularly significant as you, the graduating class of 2021, have faced unique challenges and made sacrifices for the safety and betterment of our society and as a whole. And for that, I extend my sincerest thanks, my gratitude and admiration. You have endured a great deal during the pandemic. As you look ahead to your future, I hope that you will continue to consider the following quote from Brené Brown. Ask what makes you come alive and go do it, because what the world needs is people who have come alive. This quote seems so fitting for this particular graduating class because you are change makers. Your generation is changing the way the world works, how we view one another, disrupting and changing the status quo, and making the world a more inclusive and beautiful place to live. When I think about the paths you will all take and the places you will go, I am confident to know that our collective future is in your hands because you are a generation that has come alive. The perseverance and dedication you have shown is to be admired and will serve you well as you move forward in life. Some of my favorite memories of graduation ceremonies past is looking out into the audience and seeing the look of pride and joy on the faces of friends, family members, and all of the people who supported you through this journey. I'd like to take a moment to thank each and every person that has provided support to our students along the way. Although graduation can feel like an end, I assure you it is just the beginning, and I cannot wait to see where you will go from here. Once again, congratulations to you, and I wish nothing but joy for your future, your success, and all that you desire from life.
Anin graduates, wow, to be graduating at the most powerful time in history for influencing change. The doors have been opened wide for you. This is the gift in graduating during these unprecedented times. Mother Earth is sending us a message. She needs rest and healing. And social justice is now a torch that needs to be carried. No matter what path you choose, you will have opportunities to participate in this movement and be powerful influencers. In Indigenous cultures, we believe our ancestors are always with us as we walk our life path. They give us guidance, courage, and strength to achieve our dreams. I believe you all have that guidance. Know that when more than one path presents itself, choose the heartfelt path, because that is where true wisdom lies. I know you will achieve your dreams and make this world a better place in doing so, because you already have. Congratulations. Bama P.
Good evening. On behalf of the trustees of the York Region District School Board, I offer my congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. What a challenging year this has been. I'm very happy to join you virtually to celebrate this important milestone and to recognize your achievements. You've worked hard to get here, and you should take pride in your accomplishments. This is a proud day not only for you, but also for your parents, families, and friends. I want to say a special congratulations and thank you to them for supporting you along the way. It's also a proud day for the school staff. I want to commend the teachers, support staff, and administration team for their caring and commitment, especially during such an unusual school year. Graduation is a time to look forward to the future while reflecting on the past. I hope you will treasure the memories and the friendships that you have made. I also hope you feel prepared to succeed as you move into the next phase of your life. You are somewhat like trees, with your branches of knowledge on your strong young trunks. As you age, your roots deepen, making you immovable in one respect, yet ever changing as your ideas and ideals, like leaves, shed and replenish every year. Remember to be a strong tree. I wish all of you the very best. Congratulations.
Hello, Hartman graduates, families, and friends. I'm so very honored to be a part of recognizing this achievement in your academic career. While we're not able to do so in the way that so many of us had hoped, it doesn't lessen the significance of all that you've achieved. You are moving on to an exciting new chapter in your academic journey that will bring many new opportunities to continue to discover who you truly are. I say continue to discover because I hope that your time here at Hartman, whether it was just this year or many years before, has helped lay the foundation of that discovery. I want you to think back to kindergarten for a second. What was your favorite TV show, your favorite food to eat, or even your favorite color? These things were likely pretty important in your life at that time. But I'll bet that by around grade 4, Bananas in Pajamas or Bubble Guppies wasn't your favorite show anymore, and that your favorite food was no longer mac and cheese or a hot dog. Because as you grew and changed, so did your tastes and interests. You became, dare we say it, more mature. And along with that maturity came a change in your way of thinking and your priorities as well. Now, think for a moment about what is important to you today. Of course, you still have your favorite TV shows, foods, and maybe even the same favorite color. But truly, what is important to you as an individual? Is it that you give your all each time you compete because you're a dedicated athlete? Is it that you strive to be a great listener so that you can be the best possible friend to someone who needs one? Is it that you use your voice to speak up in support of others who may not be able to use theirs? Or is it simply that you take care of and pride in yourself as you continue to discover who you are? Whatever the case may be, I encourage you to be just that, you. In the words of one of my favorite authors, Peter H. Reynolds, be you, be silly, quirky, odd, unique, weird, colorful. Be okay with being who you are, but help others to be themselves too. Try new things. Be bold. Be ready. Be okay asking for help. Go ahead. Be the best version of yourself. Each day is a new chance to be more you. Now, I recognize that saying be you is easy. It's the doing that's the hard part. But today, maybe more than ever before, there are more opportunities for each of us to be who we truly are. Our world is focused on addressing issues such as anti-Black racism, Islamophobia, Indigenous rights, and supporting 2S LGBTQ plus rights. And as you know, through your classroom discussions and various learning opportunities, we at Hartman share this commitment. You are truly living in a very special and unique time. Times like these when, to quote from one of my favorite songs, you learn to live again. Times like these you give and give again. Times like these you learn to love again. And so it is time. Time for you to learn to live again. As the world reopens and we move past the lockdowns and restrictions that have had such an impact on our lives as we battle through the pandemic that is COVID. And I do hope that you find time to give and give again. Give each person the opportunity to show you who they truly are, regardless of race, gender identity, socioeconomic status, or religion, and give yourself time to be you. And while we've missed many of the people and things we love, whether that's still mac and cheese or not, my wish for you is that you learn to love again. Find that love and connection with those who are important to you, your family and friends. And also find a new love, a love for a skill or interest not yet discovered, but more importantly, a love for yourself, just as you are. And so, as I wish you farewell, I'd like to leave you with some parting words of wisdom from the elders. Hold on to what is good, even if it's a handful of earth, for the earth is our home. Hold on to what you believe, even if it's a tree that stands by itself, for sometimes the most beautiful trees stand alone. Hold on to what you must do, even if it's a long way from here, for the journey is a lesson in itself. Hold on to your life, even if it's easier to let go, for your spirit is the spark that makes another's shine. Hold on to our hands, even if we've gone away from you, for you are always in our heart. So please keep in touch with us here at your little elementary school. We'll always be glad to see you and anxious to hear your news. And on a final note, before I say goodbye, to the teachers, I'd like to extend a sincere thank you to all of you for being a part of the lives of our students that we celebrate tonight. You made a difference. To the parents, what a fine job you've done. What a compliment to you to know that you have some of the finest students to have walked the halls of Hartman. Thank you for sharing them with us. To the graduates, congratulations. You've achieved so much already, and we're so very proud of what you've accomplished and who you have become. May you always have the wisdom and strength to follow your dreams, the courage and ambition to meet new challenges, and may you know the pride that comes with success, however that's defined for you. Best wishes and congratulations to our Hartman graduates.
The winners of this year's Art Award have demonstrated persistence in their craft, a passion for learning, and patience when the outcome may not have been what they expected. They have developed their skills in drawing and painting, working to better themselves as artists. They have inspired their peers in their dedication and willingness to make mistakes. Art is too important not to share, and their leadership in this area is recognized. The Art Award this year goes to Vanessa, Marzia, Maria, and Enkai.
The Ontario Modern Language Teacher Association states that learning a second language leads to greater appreciation of and sensitivity towards linguistic and cultural diversity in Canada and around the world. Speaking and learning French opens the door to so many opportunities in culture, the arts, cinema, fashion, travel, business, professions, and so much more. The French Award is given to a student who is an enthusiastic participant of the French program. Le prix de français est donné à un étudiant qui participe avec enthousiasme au programme de français. This student demonstrates not only academic excellence in French, but also a desire to learn more about the French language and Francophone culture. The participant this year has worked incredibly hard to develop her linguistic skills and persistently works on improving and building on her French proficiency. She demonstrates a desire to interact with French-speaking cultures respectfully. It is my pleasure and honor to present this year's Hartman French Award to Olivia. Félicitations.
This year, the Literacy Award will be presented to three students. They are enthusiastic participants, skilled communicators, and excellent writers. It has been our pleasure to have watched them present, witness how they have grown as authors, and listen to their ideas. In saying that, we were easily persuaded to choose them for this year's award. Congratulations goes to Hannah, Ava, and Noreen.
This past year in science, you explored many scientific concepts. The recipients of the Science Award demonstrated an avid effort and interest in all areas. They showed an excellent understanding of the scientific standards and enthusiastically applied these concepts to projects, tests, and discussions. Through repeated scientific experimentation, a hypothesis is about to become a theoretical fact. Congratulations to this year's Science Award winners, Adam, Yu Chan, and Peyton Bates.
Good evening, everyone. I'm here to present the Mathematics Award. The recipients of tonight's Mathematics Award have displayed an intellectual curiosity for math. Each of these students have demonstrated a superior comprehension of mathematics and have achieved excellence in all areas of math. These students were able to apply mathematical concepts to work given in class and also to practical real-life situations. Their mathematical abilities are truly exceptional. It is with great pleasure that I present this year's Math Award winners to Cynthia, Nelia, and Milos. Congratulations to the three of you on a job well done.
Human geography looks at where people live, who lives there, how they interact with the land, and why do people live there? This year's award winners were easily able to answer these questions and many more. These students possess the uncanny ability to look deeply into these topics and figure out what must have happened for that to occur. It is my extreme pleasure to present this year's Geography Awards to Alejandra, Clara, Ariel, and Owen.
Hello, friends. Mr. Wallace here. Congratulations on your graduation. This is an event that I take very seriously, as you can see. It's been a wonderful year in music. Despite our many challenges, we did an ensemble piece using the ORF instruments, a good rendition of Call Me Maybe. We used ukuleles when we worked on chording and picking melodies. And we also spent a lot of time in depth exploring the evolution of jazz music over the first half of the 20th century. And artists like Charlie Parker, John Coltrane, Miles Davis, many of the greats. Now on to our music award. Cue music. All right, our music award winner enjoys playing melodies in all 12 major and sometimes minor keys. He lists as his role model Johann Sebastian Bach, whose music we are listening to right now. So congratulations to Evan Lee for this year's music award. Everyone else, keep music close to your hearts in the future and keep on challenging yourselves. Thank you very much. Oh, jeez, how embarrassing. I forgot to shut off the camera.
All the world's a stage and all the people are merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one person in their time plays many parts. This year's winners can play them all, comedic, dramatic, and yes, one day, perhaps romantic. It is my pleasure to present this year's awards to Ava, Bailey, and Tyler.
This year's Phys Ed Award will be presented to three students. Over the past years at Hartman, these students were involved in many sports, including cross-country running, basketball, volleyball, badminton, track and field, and flag football. Despite our inability to play team sports this year, these students were still enthusiastic participants and have shown great sportsmanship, determination, and dedication both on and off the field. You will see them playing sports cooperatively during gym time, as well as at recess and after school. They are role models for all of us, and especially you, the graduating class. These students have also demonstrated a high overall grade average. They are always prepared for all classes. They consistently strive to improve their athletic performance. Being coachable is a great attribute. And finally, they demonstrate leadership in all athletic endeavors. It is with great pleasure that I present this year's Phys Ed Awards to Kyle in Mr. Jackson's class, Niaz in Mr. Carvello's class, and Cohen in Ms. Lombardi's class. Congratulations to all of you, and all the best in your future athletic endeavors.
There are so many wonderful things that make Canada great. The Grade 8 curriculum forces us to look at how we came together as a nation and the effects, good and bad, that this had. As history students, we must continually re-examine what we have done in the past and compare it to now we know better, or at least differently. This year's winners have watched, examined, dissected, and drawn conclusions about our past. They have been outstanding students of history and have been a pleasure to teach. Congratulations to Hayden, Lily, and Cassidy.
For some, perseverance is overcoming obstacles, and for others, it is the persistence in doing something despite the difficulties or in difficult circumstances. The last 2 years have proved to be more challenging than we ever imagined. And this graduating class has demonstrated grace under pressure, positivity, and a willingness to change direction with a moment's notice. They have moved from in-person to online learning, missed time with their friends, developed coping strategies, and made their teachers laugh even when the days were gloomy. It is my pleasure and honor to announce the Perseverance Award winners for this academic school year. Congratulations to Kingsman, Horton, Cassidy, and Travis.
It is now time to present the prestigious Hartman Hero Award. I am very honored and extremely excited to have the opportunity to present the Hartman Hero Award this evening. The York Region District School Board has identified 10 important character traits that all of our students strive to achieve. Throughout the school year, 6 of our graduating students have consistently demonstrated all 10 of these traits. These students are honest, fair, respectful, and responsible in day-to-day interactions. They are empathetic, courageous, and optimistic with their classmates. They display initiative, perseverance, and integrity in all of their work and in their attitude. It is a privilege for me to reveal the Hartman Hero Award for students who have continually demonstrated outstanding character. This year's award winners are Peyton A., Vanessa, Kai, Marzia, Brandon, Bianca, and Sydney Chan. Congratulations to all of you on a job very well done.
The Outstanding Achievement Award goes to a student who exhibits an enthusiasm and drive for personal academic excellence. A student who has achieved excellent standing in all facets of the Grade 8 curriculum and has the highest overall average across all strands. While it was a close contest this year, I am pleased to congratulate Cynthia Sun on receiving the Outstanding Achievement Award. The Principal's Leadership Award, which is sponsored by the Ontario Principal's Council, recognizes students who assume a variety of leadership roles within the school, act as a positive role model for others, demonstrate characteristics such as a positive attitude, responsibility, being trustworthy, reliable, and confident, among others. Typically, they are involved on many fronts within the school community and always take initiative to help wherever possible. These students respect themselves, others, and the community. While this year, unlike others, students have not been able to demonstrate this leadership within the school community itself, there have definitely been students who've demonstrated this leadership quality within their classrooms. And so this year, it is my pleasure to announce the three winners of the Principal's Leadership Award. In Ms. Lombardi's class, congratulations go to Cohen Bugeja. In Mr. Jackson's class, congratulations go to Adam Barce. And in Mr. Carvalho's class, congratulations go to Olivia Petkoff. Thank you for all you have done in demonstrating leadership within your classrooms this year.
The definition of a Hartman valedictorian is as follows. A person must be chosen by their peers and the staff to represent the graduating class. This person must have demonstrated excellence and achievement in all areas of their academic career. This person must be actively involved in school activities, have good attendance and discipline records, and excellent communication skills. They encompass the character, value, and beliefs of a Hartman hero. It has been my honor to get to know these individuals who not only meet this criteria, but have surpassed it time and time again. Ladies, gentlemen, and graduates, I present to you the valedictorians of the Hartman Public School Class of 2021, Nyla and Tyler.
Welcome, teachers, families, friends, and most importantly, graduating Class of 2021. Nyla and I are thrilled to have the opportunity of representing all of you in this year's Grade 8 graduation.
Tyler and I are excited to reflect on all of the amazing memories and accomplishments we've come across in our years as Hartman heroes.
These past years have been filled with memories, challenges, and achievements. All the clubs, sports teams, tournaments, championships, field trips, electives, I'd go on and on. Some of our best memories were from when we were younger, back when life was easy, fighting over who got to bring the milk bin up and who got to bring the attendance to the office, and consistently asking the teachers if we can go to the park.
Any excuse to get out of class, but the best excuse would be going to get changed for basketball games when we really don't have to. This graduating class has always excelled in athletic and artistic extracurriculars.
Even if we did lose in the boys' basketball finals, in double overtime, by 1 point.
Anyways, some of our biggest achievements in the sports category include the championships won by our basketball team, the wins by the flag football team and the soccer team with incredible coaching from Mr. Carvalho, Mr. Jackson, and Mr. Edwards.
And our amazing performances in the track teams and track events. The Lego robotics team did amazingly as they made it all the way to regionals in 2020. Our drama, dance, music, and art clubs have always gone above and beyond when presenting, especially in our assemblies. For example, the May Ming play, the Art Can presentation, and of course, our 10th anniversary performance. All of Hartman's work paid off in the end. We have all worked so hard and accomplished so much.
I'm sure that this year would have been another amazing year if it wasn't for COVID, which is one of the biggest challenges we faced and still are facing. At times, it became very difficult as we've been online for most of the year. Oh, and by online, I mean logging into our Google Meets and then proceeding to either sleep, play video games, or endlessly scroll through TikTok.
Still, we managed to learn many valuable lessons. I can't believe we thought COVID was just a joke or couldn't affect us.
Yeah, we saw how that turned out.
With both our moms being teachers, we've been able to witness how much time, effort, and energy it takes to teach online.
Showing up at 9 a.m. every day, teaching in front of their students. I mean, in front of their circles with letters on them. And even adjusting their plans and sometimes their teaching styles. We were lucky that we had teachers who would cook with us.
Hi, grade 8s. Welcome to Cooking with Mrs. Lombardi.
Share their music as well as teaching us how to relax.
Don't worry about a thing.
And share their songs about the days of the week.
Here we go! Tuesday, Tuesday. I'm so happy it's Tuesday.
As our grade 8 year comes to an end, we are sad that we have to leave some of our favorite teachers and staff behind us, but are eager to see what the future holds for us. We will certainly miss a lot from Hartman, like the fun fairs, popcorn days, spirit days.
No, we're too cool for those, remember?
Oh yeah, and although we dreaded walking around the school during indoor recess, you gotta admit, it was pretty fun playing manhunt and hiding in the washrooms. But we won't ever have to miss Mr. Jackson's songs, because those are already engraved in our brains.
Uh-oh, you gotta catch up to your ketchup. You gotta catch up to your ketchup. You gotta catch up to your ketchup. If you wanna put it on your plate, oh.
We've definitely grown since when we first came to Hartman. And now we're about to face a huge change, going from elementary to high school.
Before we embark on this new chapter of our lives, it's important that we thank those who have helped us reach this point. Our teachers, school staff, and the remarkable Miss Bailey and Miss Vanderbeeken have helped us tremendously reach this point and give us some ice.
Thank you for working so hard, shaping us for the future and teaching us excellence, kindness, respect, and honesty. A big thank you to our friends for always making us laugh, even when we feel at our lowest. And most importantly, thank you to our families for supporting us through all the craziness and showing us unconditional love.
To our fellow graduates, as Nancy Tillman in her book called You're Here for a Reason wrote, life can be tricky, there isn't a doubt. You'll skin your knees trying to figure it out.
But life works together, the good and the bad, the silly and the awful, the happy and the sad.
To paint a big picture, you can't always see. A picture that needs you, most definitely.
You're here for a reason. It's totally true. You're a part of a world that is counting on you.
So don't be too worried. If some days fall flat, good things can happen, even from that.
Congratulations, graduating class of 2021.